everywhere you go, you feel invited. Comes along a love, suddenly everything you had becomes ignited. You just begin to live. Comes along a love. Comes along a love, suddenly though you never sang, you're always singing. Comes along a love, suddenly chimes you never heard began a ringing. Comes along a love, suddenly night and day your heart is highland flinging. You live and you love, comes along a love. I don't care how blue you're feeling now, you sparkle and you bubble, see each bluebird double. Comes along a love, suddenly petty little things no longer faze you. Comes along a love, suddenly everyone around you seems to praise you. Comes along a love, suddenly you discover things that just amaze you. You just begin to live. Comes along a love. I don't care how blue you're feeling now. You sparkle, yes, you bubble. Look out, you got a whole lot of trouble. Comes along a love, suddenly petty little things no longer faze you. Comes along a love, suddenly everyone around you seems to praise you. Comes along a love, suddenly you discover things that just amaze you. You just begin to live and really love the day you live. Oh, while you sparkle, you bubble, well, you're in trouble, 'cause mister,
K-Star and Comes Along a Love. There we go. Right. They were only using it, as far as I know, when I went in, Laz, and that was in 75. So, I don't know. They might have been using it when Ken was in. And I don't know about that either. Right. Right, pin your lugs back, Laz. Because here is episode 14 of the Glenmidden Chronicles.
The MV Glenmidden has arrived at Oban, having stopped off in Portree to pick up some containers and portaloos to accommodate the royal family. It is a bright and breezy day, and the crew are awaiting the arrival of the royal party on deck.
This is so exciting! The MV Glenmidden being honoured with the presence of a queen. A royal one at that.
Do you think I'll have to bow and scrape like they do in the films?
I will. I'll bow, but I'll be jiggered if I'm scraping or anything.
I don't think that'll be necessary, Scotty. Anyway, seemingly they are sending an emissary on board first to tell us what's expected of us during the trip.
Well, I just hope they're not expecting too much. I'm not going to be some sort of a slave, like some concubine. They can get that out of their heads to begin with.
I don't think they'll expect you to do anything out of the ordinary, but if they do, then please do it for our sake.
No, I have my dignity and my honour to think about.
You should have talked to them 40 years ago.
Scotty, don't you know that it's rude to allude to a lady's age?
Aye, so as it might be, but you're no lady.
Maggie, how about we pay you time and a half to be nice?
Captain, I don't believe that. I'm offended that you should be offering me such a thing.
Double time?
Done.
Aye, and so we have been.
With the knotty problem of Maggie out of the way, the captain espies a strange figure making his way up the gangplank. Decked out in a uniform of the Royal Navy, this appears to be the emissary, come to give the crew a list of do's and don'ts for the royal visits.
Captain, my name is James Seymour Bottoms, and I've been sent here in advance of the royal party to inform you of certain protocols that have to be adhered to throughout the trip.
It's a pleasure to meet you, Mr. Bottoms.
Seymour Bottoms, if you don't mind. It's hyphenated.
Oh, sorry. No, it's a pleasure to meet you, Mr. Seymour Bottoms. And anything we can do to make this trip a success, we will certainly try our hardest.
Well, to begin with, you address the Queen as Her Majesty on first meeting, and then Ma'am for the rest of the trip. Never touch her, apart from shaking her hand, and never refer to her husband as that Greek ponce. Never mention Charles's ears, within earshot, and do not, under any circumstances, try to lick the side of the Queen's head as if she were a stamp. She doesn't like it. Do we have to bow and scrape like in the films? You give a slight nod of the head. Ladies, curtsy.
Oh, no, I draw the line at that. I've never curtsied in my life, and I don't intend to start now.
Double time.
You mean deep curtsy, like this?
Very good, very good. Now, can I have a look around the accommodation and also see the menu for the week?
I haven't made up the menu yet, but I was thinking of good old home cooking and maybe a cuckoo for Sunday lunch instead of a roast.
That sounds fine. I don't know if Her Majesty has had gugger before, but it sounds delicious. Now, the accommodation?
Scotty, Dick, could you take Mr. Seymour Bottoms down to the accommodation deck while I have a quick word with Maggie? Maggie, what on earth are you thinking? Gugger? Apart from anything else, it's very expensive.
Oh, don't you worry. I'm not going to actually serve gugger. No, it's a recipe my great-grandmother taught me in Barra. You see, you get a seagull, you gut it, and stuff it with some old mackerel, like my father used for the lobster pots. Then you stuff the whole thing into a sock that's been worn for about 3 months without being washed. Then you immerse it in engine oil for 24 hours, and before you can say Gordon Ramsay, no one would know it's not a gugger.
The emissary has now looked over the accommodation, and although it is not up to the standards of the R.Y. Britannia, it will have to do, as the royal party are already on their way. He has insisted the portraits of Mary Queen of Scots are removed, as they may bring back sad memories for Her Majesty. The band of the Royal Marines has arrived at the quayside, and are playing as the Queen and party are escorted up the gangplank and introduced to the crew.
Your Majesty, it's a great pleasure to welcome you and your family aboard the MV Glenmidden.
One is positive it is. Philip, don't dawdle. Charles, take care of one's luggage. The country paid a lot for that.
May I introduce you to some of the crew who will be taking care of you during the trip? First we have Eusdeen McGlumpher, our chief engineer.
Mr. McGlumpher, has one come far?
No, I don't. I've just been down to the boiler room. Excuse the grease in the horns.
Ugh, what is that odour? It smells, well, almost common.
That'll be the chip fat doll. Your engine runs in this stuff. You'll get used to it.
Quite.
Moving on. This is our cook and catering officer, Margaret McClarty.
You're majestical.
Oh, I say, what a couple of charmers. And you're going to be making sure we're fed and watered?
I will be doing my best.
Philip, keep moving.
I look forward to being waited on by a pretty filly like you, my dear.
This is Richard Woody, our deckhand, ma'am.
Charmed. And what does one do as a deckhand?
Well, I make sure that everything is in good working order and take care of the captain's wishes.
Is he a good captain? Does he treat you well?
Oh, yes, Your Majesty. He treats me like one of his own.
Mummy, could you move on a bit faster? This luggage is heavy and one's hands are almost dropping off.
Charles, stop complaining. One's on one's holidays.
Yes, you namby-pamby princess. Get a grip and stop moaning at your mother. Can't you see she's receiving?
One can see that for oneself, but if one could ask one's sovereign to get a move on, one would be grateful as one's hands are being cut through by Mummy's Louis Vuitton luggage.
Oh, I suppose he's got a point. Move on, you old trout. I need to down a quick snifter before lunch.
Captain, it appears my family would like to be taken to their quarters, if that is possible.
No problem at all. Maggie, could you take the Royal Highnesses to the suites?
This way, after you, ma'am.
Thank you, my dear.
You go next, my pretty little filly. We'll follow behind.
If you don't take your hands off my bahuki, I'll give you a right belt round the ears.
Oh, a feisty young thing. One loves it.
Hold on, hold on. No one comes on this ship without paying.
One begs one's pardon.
Don't come the high and mighty and lardy-da with me, lady. It's £15 for foot passengers.
Purser, may I introduce Her Majesty the Queen?
Are you paying for her, then?
No, it's all taken care of. I asked Scotty to give you all the details.
And that I did.
I will. I read those details, and I think you, madam, haven't read the small print. It says here, Her Majesty will travel free of charge on board the MV Glenmidden, but her escorts must be paid for.
This includes members of her family and any other passengers accompanying the said Queen. Now, by my reckoning, that's two persons here, plus the band of the Royal Marines. So, Your Majesty, you owe me £1,175. I take cash, cheque with card, or credit card.
One's never been so insulted.
Och, one must have been. You've certainly been around long enough.
Enough. Your Majesty, please excuse my overexcited purser. I will sort this out, if you like to continue to your cabins.
That's got the trip off to a good start. The purser has managed to insult the Queen and her family by asking for money. Maggie is being gloated over by Prince Philip, whilst Charles is just glad to be putting the Louis Vuitton luggage down for a bit. Will the Queen last the week? Will Philip get his way with Maggie? Will Charles ever become king? Tune in next week for some of these answers.
Hang on. Right, that was episode 14 of the Glen Midden Chronicles. There you go, lads. That's you up to date now, pal. And anybody else that's listening, of course. Yes, you're up to date with the Glen Midden Chronicles. Episode 15, tomorrow. Right, here's Andy Williams and Baby Doll.
That baby doll. Wasn't so green in ways he was smart till she hit the scene and she took him apart. He'll tell you as plain as day, keep away from baby doll.
Look out for her,
you'll see in her eyes.
Andy Williams and Baby Doll. Right now, here's Jim Dale. Be my girl, if I press the right button. Oh.
My baby, I need you.
Be my girl.
To hug you and squeeze you.
Be my girl.
I wanna do things for you. My girl, you're driving me crazy.
Be my girl.
Your kisses just thrill me.
Be my girl.
I want you to love me.
Oh, I need you.
Be my girl. But with you, it's somebody new every day. And with me, I wanna be here to stay. Oh, well, I love you so madly. So badly.